Malta, India, si no pudiese presentar el Faircon directamente desde Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. con nosotros, Brett Dalton, a.k.a. Brett Ward. Oh my God, que papi sonco. Desde Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. con nosotros, Brett Dalton, a.k.a. Brett Ward. Oh my God, que papi songo. Ooh. Right there, baby. Where you want to hit. Hi, nice to meet you.
Hola.
Hola.
Thank you.
You should do a little bit of runway and then, you know, do a little. The catwalk. There you go.
Lo siento.
Thank you, eh? Thank you, thank you. So, first time in Puerto Rico?
Sí.
You know Spanish a bit?
No.
No. Okay, just say yes to everything. You'll do fine.
Sí, ¿dónde está el baño?
¿Dónde está el baño? Okay.
Sí,
Sí, allí.
Aquí, ya.
Aquí.
Sí.
Hola, yo soy Brett.
Hola,
yeah. Yeah. How old are you?
Yeah, 55.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I'm 15 still. We never grow old, huh?
That's right.
We have the spirit.
That's right. That's all you need is the spirit. Oh, my list of questions.
Yeah, it's a mess. So you gotta help me figure out the order. I'm gonna do my best.
Si
ven los números, esto está numerado, pero como que bien al garete. I'm gonna try to do the best.
We don't have to get to the list. It's okay.
Yeah, I mean, we have lots of questions from the public, so, right?
We do!
Yeah.
So, can I take a little video of everyone here?
Yeah.
Would that be okay with everyone?
Yeah.
You want to come with
me? Sure. They're usually a bit shy, so.
Okay, yeah, I can tell. I can tell.
So.
Okay.
So maybe they'll surprise us.
We'll do it on three, okay?
Okay.
Uno, dos. Tres.
Puerto Rico!
Puerto Rico!
We're here! Yeah! You started acting when you were back in high school.
See?
Yeah?
What's gonna happen? Punishment? If I don't answer the question right?
No, okay, I'm gonna put down my pen
so
you'll relax.
Hello. Yes, yeah. In high school, I wanted to get into college, and I thought it would look good on a college resume. So I auditioned for One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest.
Yeah, the play based on a novel.
And I fell in love with acting.
And you said, this is it.
I said, this is it.
I found my passion.
And I never looked back. Yeah,
it
was great.
You never looked back.
Yeah.
And you went to Yale. And you went to Yale. Yeah, with the School of Drama, and Lupita was your classmate, Lupita Nyong'o. Do you still keep in touch with her? Since she won the Grammy, no? She doesn't look at you anymore?
I try. She's doing okay.
Actually.
She's doing okay. Yeah, we're all very close. We're very excited when somebody else from our school is doing well, and we were all wishing her the best, and we still are. And hopefully, you know, when I win my Academy Award as well, we will cheers.
Yeah. So, but the interesting thing is that you not only did acting, you also did some voice acting.
Yeah.
And
Until
for
Dawn.
A lot of films, cartoon series.
Cartoons and the video game Until Dawn. How do you say, ¿cómo se dice Until Dawn en español?
Antes del amanecer, yeah. It doesn't sound the same though.
No, it doesn't.
No. Until Dawn sounds more cool. But yeah, you did like a cartoon series, Robot Chicken, Jack and the Neverland Pirates, Milo Murphy's Law. But from my experience, like, usually voice acting, or people that do voice acting, not always...
I'm very sexy.
Yeah, they're very sexy. But usually, like, they don't have acting skills. The ones that start doing voice acting, they're usually very good, you know, delivery. But when the camera's on, they don't. Not all of them get to transition into the big screen.
Yeah.
But you had it the other way around. You did acting first, and then you did the voice acting, and it's different, right? How you deliver when you're in front of the camera and when you project on a mic.
Yeah. Well, you know, the technology has come so far that they put a camera on your head, they put the dots on your face, and it's just like acting. And in fact, the way they cast it, they held auditions just like they would a normal play or a movie. So they wanted actors, they didn't want voice actors. If they wanted voice actors, they have a reel, and you have your voice samples, 2 minutes of your voice samples. And they would have just listened and went, uh-huh, no, 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 okay, that guy. But they didn't, they held it, and you know, I was in the room with everybody, and they held it like a regular audition.
When you say they put the dots in your face,
yeah.
What are the dots?
Mascara, like, dots.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, so that's interesting.
Yeah. I put on mascara anyway, so you know, it's just...
Yeah. But your wrinkles look good on you, you don't need it.
Oh, like, thank you.
And the concealer and stuff. They look interesting.
Did you just cheer for wrinkles?
Yeah.
I love Puerto Rico.
Yeah. So, ¿qué? Tostones. Mofongo. Yeah, you haven't had our food yet, right?
Yes, I have.
You did.
I got mofongo.
Last night?
Yes. Yeah. 2 nights ago.
Wow. That's good. Rice and beans, mofongo. So did you like it?
I love it. And anything with plantains.
See?
You put a plantain in anything, I'll eat it.
Cualquier cosa con plátano. Plantain is plátano in Spanish.
Yeah.
Okay. So, how do you compare the preparation process from being in a live action TV series to being a voice actor?
I don't know. I mean, it's the same work. It's the same work. So, I don't know, you know your lines, and you know where you're going to stand, and...
Easier, actually. You get to read them, right?
Yeah, in that sense it is, because you with a video game like that, you have different alternates. You have a whole bunch of separate scenarios. It's like a create your own adventure kind of thing. So, it was kind of impossible. You'd get completely confused, so we had a screen that was showing us our lines, so... That's very helpful.
Yeah, definitely. Okay, so what else can we ask you? How do you prepare for your characters? Like, you do a little bit of research, consulting, when we talk about Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. in this case. We want to know, like, the process from Grant Ward, from S.H.I.E.L.D. agent to Hydra to becoming Hive.
Yeah, well, I mean, I'm just very lucky to have had a chance to play three different characters in one TV show. I got to play the good guy, the anti-hero, the really bad guy, well, and then Hive as well. So, an alien, like, inhuman.
Right. And for you, what would be your favorite role?
I like evil Grant Ward.
Yeah.
There's a lot. Well, this is not a line, but my favorite moment was when Grant Ward was still a good guy, episode 13, and he tried to turn on the holocom table, and he's trying to turn it on, and he's like, activate. Yeah. Okay, one person knows what I'm talking
about. They can relate.
One person. So I've reached one person. That's okay. But
you've
I'm
reached
trying
a few.
Two people.
Yeah.
But three. I'm trying to turn the thing on and it doesn't quite work and I'm looking around. And that was like, I did that for like 6 minutes. and they just let me go and go and go and go. And they only used what they wanted to use, but I just went there forever. I love doing that stuff. It's so fun. And I'm kind of a goofy guy, so it's very interesting that I got to play somebody who's...
So what else do you enjoy, like, being on the set? What would you, like, what experience can you bring to us from being on set, and why do you enjoy it so much? And
I thankfully found something that I really love to do, and I get paid for it. And
of course.
Yeah, and also it seems like I don't know. This is always, as soon as I discovered it, uh-huh. I was like, this is you understand so much about yourself and other people, and you never know what's gonna happen on set. You never know. Even now that I'm sadly no longer on the show. Uh-huh. I know, que lastima, huh? It is. I'm very sad.
But other plans are coming up, right?
Yeah, so I have some other things. So, like, even now, I don't know where my next big show is going to be, but whatever it is next is going to be exciting. So, for some people, like, that uncertainty can be scary.
Right.
But for me, it's exciting, because mm-hmm. it's anything. Mm-hmm. So if you guys are making a movie, let me know, okay?
You have to...
Because I'm available now.
Well, actually, he is, but you have a film coming up.
I have two films coming out in January. Yes, thank you. One film, I'm just trying to turn on the holocom. It's an hour and a half of me just trying to turn on the table. Some people might not like it, but I do.
She watched it 20 times.
No, one of the films is called Lost in Florence, and it's about this game that they play over there. It's really violent over there in Florence. Obviously, Lost in Florence takes place in Florence.
Uh-huh.
It's kind of a romantic comedy. He finds out who he is through this sport. And then also the other film that is coming out is The Resurrection of Gavin Stone. It's a feel-good movie about a guy who gets a second chance.
You play Gavin.
I play Gavin.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that's coming up for 2017. That's good. You have projects on your hands.
Exactly. And Ming-Na Wen from our show. She's here! Sorry.
You're a funny guy. He's very funny. Like, well, you like to play jokes on people, right?
No, but huh? She is, Ming-Na Wen and I, we play time-traveling agents on a show called Milo Murphy's Law. It's a cartoon with Weird Al Yankovic.
Woo!
How do you say weird in Espanol?
Weird, raro. Raro. Yeah, he's still alive?
Yeah! Yes, he's still alive. It's still weird.
He's still weird.
And so anyway, he plays the main character. There's a lot of music and stuff, and it's very, very fun.
And your character is Brick, right? Brick, it says Brick from Milo Murphy's Law.
Yeah, that's him.
Okay, so what can you tell us about Brick?
He's a time-traveling agent, and Milo Murphy, there's this thing in, like, the Irish culture, you know, Murphy's Law,
uh-huh.
has become kind of universal.
Uh-huh, yeah.
Anything bad that can happen will happen.
Uh-huh.
And so this Milo travels back in time, and he messes up the world, and we have to fix it every episode. Yeah,
come save it. It's a cartoon series, and it just started in Disney.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Disney, so, yay!
Any advice?
Ming-Na
Wen! It's her birthday.
Oh, it's her birthday?
Yeah, she deserves to be the first runner-up for questions, right?
Feliz cumpleaños.
You want to give her a chance for a question?
Huh?
You want to give her a chance for a question?
Ming-Na Wen?
Right now?
Oh, her?
It's her birthday. It's her birthday. We're going to party like... Bueno, te lo ganaste.
Preguntas.
¿Quién cumple tú, verdad?
I was the one crying and grabbing onto your shoulder. I'm still not okay about that. I love you and you're amazing. I wanted to ask you, what was your reaction when you found out that you were gonna get, like, killed and then turned into Hive?
I was like, what?
Are you serious?
And then they said, yeah, but you're still alive. And I said, okay, that's fine.
Great question, Maria. Do we have someone in the back? Okay, we're alternating from the front stage.
Oh, in the VIP. Hey, buddy.
Yeah.
How are you? ¿Qué pasa?
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. All right, my question is, knowing that the Marvel Universe is so complex and there's a lot of stuff going on, especially magic now on the show, the element of magic, would you like to see Grant Ward return to the show at some point, or do you think creatively he's given the show as much as he's gonna?
No way, man. Yes, yes, Grant Ward should be back on the show. 100%. As a robot. I mean, one of the things about Grant Ward is he started as a good guy, as part of Phil Coulson's team of ragtag agents trying to, you know, keep the world safe. And he started out as a good guy, and then he turned kind of bad. You found out he was actually a spy. All of this stuff happened. We always kept expecting him to have a redemption and for him to be, you know, to actually turn to the good side again. He never got that redemption. So if you brought him back as a robot, he would be a neutral Grant Ward, and maybe he's a good guy. As a LMD, a live model decoy. So, Grant Ward, Grant Ward,
Grant Ward, Grant Ward!
Put him in the writer's room, right? Just in the writer's room.
What?
Put you in the writer's room.
Yes, yes.
All right,
yes.
Thank you.
Let the writers know. All right.
Okay, Omari's here has a question.
Hi, what was your favorite scene shooting Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. and why?
Everybody was kneeling, so I thought I would too. My favorite scene?
Shooting Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D.
Yeah, I mean, as I said, turning on the holocom thing was pretty fun.
Thank you.
I would say maybe my least favorite scene was when I was skydiving in episode 5, and my hair didn't move.
With a big screen on
the whole time, right? I'm going like this in front of a green screen, and I felt really
ridiculous.
Wasn't
I supposed to be doing it for real?
No,
wouldn't have you.
Yeah. No, I did not do it for real.
Have you done skydiving?
No.
And you would have liked it, no?
I've done bungee jumping.
Okay.
But not
yeah.
skydiving.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you're not afraid of heights at all?
No.
Okay. Who sells in the back?
Hello. Hola.
Hola. ¿Y cuál es tu disfraz?
¿De qué estás? Quake.
Quake. Okay.
And well, my question for you is, well, Grant Ward being, you know, the traitor he is for betraying S.H.I.E.L.D. and all of that. My question is, being as we're right now, you know, Brett Dalton and not Grant Ward, will you still choose siding with Hydra or will you stay with S.H.I.E.L.D.?
Hydra! Easy!
Well, you know what? I'm not sorry for letting you die until dawn.
Oh! Why you gotta do that, man? I was gonna let you walk the runway! As you should. Goodness. All right, Quake. All right.
He's participating at the cosplay showcase later on.
I see.
Yeah.
Well, Hoey?
Hoey has a question.
Are we right?
Hoey!
Okay, so what advice would you give, like, aspiring actors in this business?
Oh, man. What, like, any advice?
Are three main things that you need to have.
The three things that you need to have?
At least, huh?
You need to be slightly crazy.
Yeah.
I think you have to want it more than anything else. I mean, there's so many easier things to do in the world than this. But if you really love it for the work and not going to a party with a red carpet, any of that other stuff, that's great, but for me, I'm in it for the work, and actually everybody on our show is in it for the work as well, so thank you. Yes, and we have kind of a no jerk policy. How do you say it in Spanish? Like a Okay, we'll leave that okay. Okay, everybody on our show is really, they're good people, and they work really, really, really hard. Okay, that's what I feel like.
You don't want any snobs like on the show. No snobs, no rude people.
Yes, exactly, exactly. So everybody on our show is not just a good actor, they're also good people. And all of the people that I've met who are really successful are also, at the end of the day, good people. I know that there's some stories sometimes of demanding actors and stuff like that, but I've yet to meet any, on our show. So it's everybody loves what we do, and you know, we just I'm glad you guys are here to watch it, because that means a lot. You know, we do this work hours on end, and we're just happy that you guys are happy. So thank you for that.
Muy bien, y acá. Así que lo importante es hacerlo porque uno le gusta, no por la fama, porque realmente al final del camino sigue siendo trabajo. The important thing is to do it because you love it, not because of the fame and limelight. It's, you know, because at the end of the day, it still work. And,
that's if you enjoy it, reward. It won't. It's its own reward. Exactly.
Right.
The work is its own reward.
Right.
Everything else is just
frosting.
The cherry on top.
The cherry on top.
Exactly.
So we'll
see my friend.
Hydra.
Huh?
El Hydra.
Ah, yeah.
Oh, Hydra.
Hey, my question is, what inspired you to take the role of Agent Grant Ward, or what did you like about him that made you want to take the role?
Well, that's very easy. I auditioned and they said, you're hired. So I said, okay. But I auditioned for a lot of things. So I wasn't just sitting around, like, sort of looking at scripts going, oh, I want to do that job, but I don't want to do that. No, I mean, I was just starting out in my career. So I auditioned for a lot of things. They said yes to me. I was very skinny. I'd never thrown a punch in my life. Never ridden a motorcycle. Never done any of this cool action stuff that they wanted from me. But they took a chance on me. And I felt very lucky, and I thought that they must have seen something in me that maybe I didn't see myself. So I just worked hard, and they taught me how to ride the motorcycle and throw a punch.
Have you fallen off the motorcycle?
And walk the runway, and all this other incredible stuff. So yes, they said yes to me, and I gave them 110% because of it.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Have you fallen from the motorcycle?
Have I fallen?
Yeah.
No, don't jinx me.
No, not even once.
Not once, no.
Do you have a motorcycle?
I've stolen a motorcycle. I have a moped.
No, una mopeda. Okay, that's as close to the motorcycle you get.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So it took a lot of months of training, like physically, gym time,
yeah,
pumping
yeah,
iron.
Exactly, but these are good problems to have. If you need to get bigger and look better,
right?
And you need to get into better shape. That's a good problem to have.
But you don't look like the type of doing exercise all the time, like unless you're being prepared for a role, right? Or are you into the gym and stuff?
No, I was not. I like never went to the gym before
getting
cast in this show, so it forced me.
It forced you, and
that was
one of the, I'd say, hardest things to get ready for, physically, mentally?
Maybe mentally.
And discipline-wise?
Yeah.
Wake up early, train?
Well, I mean, that's just physical, that's something, but, you know, I come from theater.
Mm-hmm.
It just helps me concentrate, okay?
Okay, you can have it for now.
I come from theater, though, which is totally different than TV and film, and so a typical day on set is 12 hours, you're doing the same scene, sometimes two pages long, over and over and over again.